Adhiban, today you had a great win.
Yeah,
and the Indian team is on the verge of winning the match. But let's first go
I should add.
Let's first go to your game. How was it?
Yeah, it was this Rylopus Archangel and...
Was it your preparation?
No, I was not at all expecting this line. It was a surprise. But as always, I coped with the situation at hand and... the thing is, I was having these two bishops, which made me very happy. So I was like, okay, now I'll just control the game. But at some point, it got very interesting when I think he played Rook E7, Rook B7. Instead of that, I think Rook C7, if he had played, it was very unclear and I was really not sure. Because my bishop on B1 is kind of stuck and as long as it remains there, my back rank will be very weak. So I was really concerned about Rook C7. But after Rook E7, Rook E3, I felt I was in control. But still, till the last moment, okay, it was a total, I think, complex game. Yeah.
And you were not in danger at any point. Did you calculate any good lines which you could share with us?
Yeah, for example, there are many lines I calculated. There was, I think one line which was very interesting was Rook C7 instead of Rook E7, like I mentioned. And then the problem is now Black is threatening Rook into C3. Yeah, Rook into C3 followed by Rook C3, BC3, Knight F3 check. Now the point is Bishop is not protecting the Rook on E1. So I have to take Queen into, I cannot take Queen into F3. That's the whole point. It was like after Rook C7, I thought Bishop D3 was very nice. The point is if he takes Bishop D3, then I take Queen D3. And he cannot take Knight D3 because of Rook E8 check and Bishop into F6. And I win exchange. But after Bishop D3, he can go Rook C3 and Bishop into B5. I thought it was winning at first, but then Knight F3 check and I'm losing the Queen. So this line was really, that's why Rook C7, I was really not sure. I was calculating Queen B4, which was, the whole point is I keep protecting the Rook on E1. But Queen B4, I think, will be met by Knight F3 check, GF3. Rook E1, Bishop E1 and Rook C1. This is a very nice line, I thought. Like just a piece down, but Black has like a very fantastic attack, but probably it's even winning. So for Rook C7, I thought Queen E3. This was my idea. So the point is now, he doesn't have this Knight F3 check. So Knight F3, I'll just take GF3 and I'm doing fine. Yeah, GF3, Rook E3, I should tell this line. Rook A8 check, it's very important and then I'm winning. Then because I can take Bishop F6 with check. So yeah, Queen E3, I'm still in control, but it was really not sure. But Queen E3, the point is now I'll put Bishop E4 and then F4 and I think I should be better. So, but yeah, this was probably the line. And even after Rook E7, there are a lot of very interesting lines. Rook E7, I played Rook E3, now I just, this back rank issue I don't have to worry about. Then he went for this Queen G5, which was really provocative. We should have played something else. Queen G5, I think he just missed something. F4, F5, this was nice. And now I went, the point is Queen D4, if I go Knight F3 check. Rook F3, Rook E1, and I'm getting mated. Bishop E1, Rook E1, and Rook E2, and I'm getting mated. So I have to play Queen B4, so that when he goes Knight F3, I can have Rook F3 and protect the E1 square. So after F4, he went Queen H6. And now, F4, F5, now Queen F4, F5, Queen B4, Queen H6. And now, the point was if I take Queen into B5, then he has Knight G4. And Rook E7, he just takes Rook E7. No, Rook E7, I think, yeah, Queen H2 check, yeah, it's just lost. And if I go Queen E8 check, which is nice. Nice x-ray, but Rook E8, King F7, and I just don't like this position because he gets Queen H2, Queen H1, everything is coming. So, yeah, that's why I had to reject this line, and after so I cannot play Queen B5, so that's why I was forced to find this H3. There's one more funny line, which was Bishop E5, which looks very natural, Rook E5, and the problem is now Fe5 I cannot take because he just gives Queen E3 check. This I missed at first. I was calculating Queen C1, King F2. But Queen E3 and Queen C1, it's just made. So Rook E5. Now I was checking some Queen B5. But it was like really, I was not at all happy for some reason. I think some queen f4 and it was, maybe it's fine, but I was just not entirely happy. So that's why I played this h3, which looks very safe. But then he made it very interesting with knight c4. I was expecting something like bishop d7 because I still cannot take on e5. Bishop d7, then I'll come queen d4, knight f7, rook e7. Now he is almost in zugzwang. I can just play bishop d3 or queen f6 and just it should be winning. But knight c4 was fun. I play rook e7. Now the point is, if I take queen, I took queen b5, queen f4. Now the point is queen c1 check, queen f4. It threatens a perpetual. So, and I don't have time for this. So that's why bishop d3 I felt was very strong. First I was calculating bishop and f5 just to get rid of this bishop and protect the first rank. But just g5 and the king, I'm not able to mate the king. So that's why I found this bishop d3 very strong move, which I think just wins on the spot. So the point is, for he has to take the bishop, queen e3 check, and now I have this king h2. And now it goes away from all the checks. And queen d3, and now I have this just rook a, queen b8, and forced mating attack. Yeah, so he just resigned.
Oh, what mind-boggling calculations they were! I think you were in top form, today.
Yeah, I think it was like I was calculating quite well since I had like too many rest days. So I was feeling very fresh.
So tell us a bit about the mood in the camp yesterday, because it was a very tough game against USA. We lost 2.5.
It was not so tough, I would say. Just I think Vishy was doing fine. Just he missed some calculation, and so apart from that, I think everything was okay. Like Vidit was slightly worse, but then he defended and it was draw. And Hari's game, he did not get much, I think, out of the opening. So, and Wesley is very solid. So, I don't know, it was funny. I read some comments that in chess bomb that Hari has a bad score with Wesley. But I asked him, it is not at all. Apparently, they have an equal score or something. So, I don't think we were much in danger. Maybe, I don't know, Sashi could have tried, I'm not sure. But computer is just telling equal in the last question. So I think overall it was a good match, just unfortunate that we lost.
So it was not like you were sad or anything, you were fired up for the next game.
I always say there's no point in crying about it now. There's still a long tournament, and if we eventually don't make it, then we cry. Otherwise we just, most of the time if you just play well, there's no reason to feel bad. Because still there are a lot of rounds, and they have to meet a lot of strong teams. So, and Olympiad, you never know, because every team is super inspired and they want to give their best. Like no match is so easy for them. So we just have to keep winning and hope to catch up to them.
And what was the idea of giving rest to Vidit today? Any particular reason?
I think he just wanted to. He wanted a lot of time to get ready for the Bermuda party. That's that's the reason.
Will you be there at the Bermuda party?
No. Like I was telling in the other interview that I've been playing this Olympiad for this is my fourth Olympiad.
Oh.
So I know already.
You're already a veteran.
Yeah, veteran. this is the exact word it was used. Like I was a veteran, though he's still young. I think I'll just skip it this time, because I wanted to, with wishing the team, I just wanted to give all of us, to give our best. So I think I'll skip it this time.
So the entire team would be skipping Bermuda party or?
No, come on, I just told you Vidit will be there. So whoever is watching this, Vidit will be there for sure. And I don't know about the rest, I guess.
Yeah, but without you, the flavor might be a missing.
I know, the best moments in the Bermuda party are when I'm there. But last time I remember, we even made a train at some point. It was so funny. But this time, we are looking for the gold, so I have to take it seriously.
You are saying this, that you are going to give a Bermuda party a skip this time.
Yeah.
What are the other differences that you feel from 2016 or 14 and 2018?
Apart from Vishy in the team?
Yes. Apart from Vishy, but I think there will be a lot of other differences because of that as well.
No. For example, 2014, there is always this running joke that we didn't meet any of the strong teams, so we got lucky. But we proved it in 2016 that, we are not a joke. We are a super team now. And we just, all of us are, I think, in good spirits and good form. So our main difference, Okay, the thing is, there's always this big problem which comes with expectations. I think this is the only difference. Like 2014, we were like nobody. So when we got a bronze, it was like a huge bonus. And 2016, already we knew that we had got a bronze. So maybe the expectation was already kicking in. But now it's just in a different level also, because the Federation did so much that indirectly, okay, they want us to, I know they don't want us to have any pressure, but they did so much for us that it feels like we have to do something. So maybe, but I think we should just forget about it.
You handle the pressure pretty well.
Yeah. Yeah, but I don't know about the rest of the team. Yeah.
Okay. You're worried about them.
Yeah, okay. I don't know. VD is probably by now used to it. Okay, Vishy has played all the super tournaments, yeah. Probably, you know, isn't it? And Hari is always chilled out. And Saji is very patriotic when it comes to team events. So I think, we can handle it. Yeah, after all, it's part of being a sports person, yeah.
And how is the food overall? I think you are being served Indian food. Is
yeah,
this
yeah,
true?
No. This our federation did some deal with some Indian restaurant. So we are getting Indian, very good Indian food whenever we want it. And actually, only disappointment is this hotel, Radisson Blue, where we are staying is, like, for example, lunch, we cannot really order because it takes some time, and we would prefer to have it down, and like dinner, we would go all out. But lunch is not so good, actually, the Radisson Blue, yeah. Maybe Hilton is better, but also people are complaining. People who are staying in Hilton are complaining. So, but anyway, like, we have this Indian restaurant when we want it, so we have no trouble about food, yeah.
So apart from lunches and dinners, do you guys meet up and do you...
Yes, actually, now that you mentioned, in 2016, we were going for walks after breakfast. This was missing this time, actually. Somehow, only today when I was going, when I went with Hari, we realized that we were having like a different kind of routine. We spent more time as a team, but this time we were not spending. Maybe this is a crucial thing which we need to fix before the rest day we should use it for that. I think this team bondage was much more last time. This time somehow we have different timings and we are not meeting so much. This maybe we need to fix it. I think this is one of the key things when it comes to
maybe
team.
Maybe all of you have become much stronger than last time and much more as a players. You have all progressed quite
yeah,
a bit.
We have progressed as a player, but still I think this like team thing is, I think team spirit is still doing well, but I think we should spend more time. Yeah, now that you mentioned it, yeah, I have to make sure.
You will take it upon yourself to do this.
Yeah. Why not?
Okay.
Yeah, like Vishy mentioned, yeah, that I'm the glue which bonds the team together. So it's up to me.
Yeah. Vishy also said that it was very nice to see that Adhiban had only slightly minus position, not 4 points down at one point.
Yeah. Like Ramesh is spreading wrong rumors that I was exchange up and 3 points down last Olympiad. I wanted to set the record straight that it was exchange down and pawn down. Yeah, this was the right thing, not like exchange up. I don't want people to assume that I was exchange up and did not have 3 points. I was exchange down, pawn down. And yeah, probably should also not check my games from Tromso Olympiad 2014. Also, Ari said, once the tournament is over, you'll check, not right now.
Sure, and last question to you. Yes. We have been asking this to everyone. What has been the impact of Chessbase in your life, the website, the softwares and everything included?
Yeah, okay. Chessbase has changed, I think, so many people's life, and I'm one of them. Like, for example, I think it was the first platform which gave me a lot of publicity when I won, when I came second in the Asian 2014, that was one of the things. And also the picture which the Chessbase, like main guy, Frederick took, I think it was like 2008 or something, and it was everywhere. So I'm like grateful to them. And also we have this clouds and so many features which are so useful for the chess player. And even like 2 days back, I got this CBM from Stephens. Like now the CBM is available to download, so I was very happy.
186.
Yeah, 186. So, yeah, they just keep, I think, helping everyone, and I'm just very grateful to them, actually.
Well, Adhiban, we wish you good luck and also take good rest.
Yeah. No more rest. I already took so much rest. Come on,
rest
want to play
day tomorrow.
Yeah, apart from the rest day, yes. I hope I won't be given so many rest again. So, yeah.
Good luck.
Yeah, thanks. Bye.